attorney in a team of attorneys that are picking up the fight against the illegal, or what we feel is the improper tool.
Okay, let me, I think what may be useful to people is give an update on where the case is at, what the next steps are, what's going to occur. The county court judge issued his decision on January 8th. I actually got a copy of it on about the 14th. So the next step in the appeal process is to seek leave from the Court of Appeals, which is the highest appellate court in the state of New York. That's done through what's called a leave application. And at the same time, a stay application, stay of sentence, can also be sought from the Court of Appeals. There was a stay issued by the county court pending its decision, but now that that decision has been issued, you have to seek a further stay of sentence from the Court of Appeals. The trial level court is actually not involved in that process at this point in time yet. The reason we're here tonight is once a decision is reached on the order, you have to return to the local court for execution of any sentence that remains, and that's why we're here tonight for that purpose. There are some legal steps that have to be taken before that can occur, but that should occur tonight. The leave application is being prepared. The main issues in the leave application relate, of course, to the order of protection, and particularly the issues related, and I won't go into great detail, I'm happy to answer questions if people have them. The expansion of the legal term victim and witness have been expanded in this case in a way that's new and unique in the state of New York. And so that'll be one of the key issues there, and that all relates to the validity in the overall application of the order of protection in the case. I think one of the great ironies in this case is, as was developed at trial, that if not for what was probably a case of mistaken identity, Mary Anne would never have been arrested and charged. She was initially believed to be one of the eight protesters when she wouldn't. That led to her arrest. She was actually about a half a mile away going to get coffee when she was arrested.
They thought it was my sister. I was my sister.
And that's why you see the acquittal on the disorderly conduct charge. I think the jury figured that out, that she wasn't one of the actual protesters there. But it's one of the ironies in this case as we go forward.
Thank you.
Yep.